serious? Are you serious? Word on the street. Word on the street, of course, from our own sources. So no link provided. But word on the street is Saudi Arabia has sent surface-to-air missile capability to Syria to help the Free Syrian Army to fight against the Iranians and the Assad, President Assad's Air Force, primarily President Assad's Air Force, but you can know this, Saudi Arabia will shoot and would love to see an Iranian plane shot out of the sky. They are arch enemies, as Saudi Arabia is Sunni Muslims and Iran is Shiite. And they definitely don't get along. Matter of fact, if you remember, I believe it was in 2009 or 2010, Iran tried to assassinate one of the Saudi crown prince at a restaurant during the United Nations General Assembly that was going on. So, well, there's a lot of bad blood there. And oh, by the way, the reason that this hostile takeover of the Yemen's government has been done by the Houthi rebels, well, the Houthi rebels are totally funded and supported by the Iranians. And then the Houthis, after taking over Yemen, then started fighting with the Saudi Arabians along the border. So this goes way back, folks. Let me tell you something. Since America has backed out and since Russia has taken control of the Syrian situation in conjunction with Hezbollah, with Assad's armies, and with the Iranians, the Russians, now what's happened is it's created a vacuum for all kinds of radical Islamic behavior that may take place. And all it will do is bring more confusion. It will add to the confusion and the bloodshed in the Middle East. Meanwhile, the Palestinians continue to stab the Israelis near holy sites. And John F. Kerry, the United States Secretary of State, decided to go to Berlin to meet with some, including Netanyahu and some others, and Angela Merkel. And now he's in Jordan meeting with King Abdullah II, trying to bring peace to the Middle East. I mean, it's insane, but he's trying. So that's where we're at. Word on the street. Surface-to-air missile systems being sent by the Saudi Arabians to fight against Assad and his armies in the battle in Syria. I'll be back with more current world events, how they relate to Bible prophecy, as we are truly living in the last days, and Jesus Christ coming soon. Don't be left behind.